Hello everyone, how are you doing today? Welcome to the video series on Git, one of the most widely used and popular source control tool. Now, in this particular video, we will talk about branching in Git, but just a reminder that if you are new to Git, I will highly recommend you to see my introductory videos on Git. You can see a card over here. Now, branching itself is a very complicated thing, but in this video, I am gonna start with very simple branching strategy, how to create branch and merge it back so that you get a basic understanding of what branching looks like and how you can make use of the same. We will go into more details of branching in upcoming videos. So let's go ahead and start. So you can see my presentation. I'll just do a small recap before explaining you about branching. Reminder, Git is a distributed version control system, which means that when you clone a repo into your local system itself work as a version control system. Now, Git store data as a snapshot. It doesn't store the difference. So when you do your first commit, create a snapshot. Second commit creates a snapshot. Again, with the third commit, it creates a snapshot. And what it does to keep the information about previous snapshot is that you can consider this as a reverse linked list. It has a pointer to the previous snapshot. This is a generalized representation of how snapshot works in case of multiple commits. I'm deliberately not going into the detail because I do not want to confuse you. The exact mechanism I will tell you in upcoming videos, but this is how it looks like in simplified term. Now let's understand branches. Before I go ahead and show you how you can create branches, first understand the purpose of branches. Now, in all organizations and for all the products, there will be a master branch, which is, you know, production ready, from where you take the code and ship it to the production, right? So what happens when you want to change something in that particular code? You can change it in the master branch itself. There is no limitation to that, but if something goes wrong, then your production ready code will have bug and you need to revert back to the last build which was successful, right? You can do all these things, but imagine when multiple people are checking in the code, writing new code, and everybody is putting things into the master branch, it will be very difficult to understand what causes this problem. So that's the precise reason whenever people want to develop something, they create a branch from the master branch, let's call it develop. And what they do is that they do all the code changes in the develop branch or whatever name you have for your branch. And then what people do is that they develop, test and confirm. And once they are sure that everything works fine, they merge the code to the master branch. And this is what we are gonna see today. So let's go ahead and see the code. So just like what I did in my last video, I have created a repository which I have created in last video called Learn Git, and we are gonna use this particular repo over here. And if I go to my Git bash, I am in the folder where this Learn Git is. And if I go ahead and say git status, my branch is up to date, local is up to date with whatever is there in my GitHub page, okay? Now this is my master branch and I want to do some change. For example, suppose I want to add a new file. For that, I need to create a branch, okay? But before that, just see git log -- one line. Don't worry about these commands. Decorate. So you can see that right now my head is in master, that is the local master. So my head is in master branch, okay? So let me create a new branch. To create a new branch, the syntax is extremely simple. You need to say git branch. What must we name it? Develop, D-E-V-L-O-P, correct? Now I have two branches. Now remember, this branch I have created in my local machine. I haven't uploaded it to my GitHub page. So if you go back to GitHub page, and even if you refresh it, you can see there is only one branch right now. Okay, again, git status, nothing. Now if I go ahead and do log again, you can see that head is in master as well as in develop. Both are having same head pointer. Well, I do not want to confuse you, but consider head pointer as a snapshot, which I have shown you in the presentation sometime back. Okay, so the head is in master. Now to do any change in my develop branch, I need to go to that branch. I can do it by saying get checkout. Checkout is a way to going to a branch develop. Okay, it is saying to me that switched to branch develop. And if I say get status, you can see on branch develop. And if I go ahead and do a log, you can see that head is pointing to develop because I am now in develop branch, but there is no difference between master and develop. They are same. Now let me create a new file. So I'll say vi develop file dot txt. I'll just add this is a new file. And I'll say wq. Okay, just like I have told you in last video, if I say get status, it will tell me what all things are in modified state. So I'll say git add develop file.txt, and after that if I say git status, you will see that it is in stage state. I can say git commit minus m. I'll say first let me put the comment as first commit in develop branch. Okay, I have committed it and my git status should be clean, right? Nothing to commit, working tree is clean. Now I have added one new file in my local branch, which is develop. So let's go ahead and see the log again. Okay, now you can see that head is in develop and origin master and master is in some other place. So what this is saying is that this is the snapshot ID. You can see it is just a hash, but please don't get confused right now. Right now what Git has did is that it has taken a snapshot right now, and the snapshot is of develop branch, and master branch is having a different snapshot because I am now moved away from master branch and I have changed that. So change will create a snapshot. Now if you go back to my GitHub page, still it is having only one branch, right? It has not created any branch. So in general what happens that whenever I created a branch, I may not be able to complete all the work in one day, and I want to submit this branch to the remote server or GitHub in my case. How will I do that? Before merging, let's talk about this scenario. You remember I talked about something called git remote, from where I have cloned the same. So last time when we wanted to put some change into the master branch, what we used to say git post origin master, right? But right now we are in develop branch, we will say git post origin develop, and it will take some time, but it will do it. Okay, so if you say git status, nothing to commit, and my branch is develop. So if I go ahead and refresh my GitHub page, you can see here there are two branches. Can you see it? And if you click over here, you can see that develop branch is there. Now one trick, if you are using GitHub, you can see the visual representation by going to insights and network. You can see that right now master is there, develop is there. It is very small. You can just save the image and try to zoom it, but this is how it looks like. The network will show you the diagram, network diagram. Let's come back to git, and again I have two branches, right? I might be keeping it for safety purpose because I might be doing something over a period of month or so. Now let's come back to our git bash. Now we have, go back to git log. I have something in develop which is not in master. My ultimate aim is when my develop is completed, I need to merge the same to master. So to merge a branch, you need to go to the branch which needs to be merged. So we have to go to master. How to go to a branch? Git checkout master. Okay, now you have to merge it. You say git merge develop, done. If you see git status over here, it is again working tree clean. And if you go back to the log, you can see that head belongs to master as well as develop. Okay, so right now both are having same snapshot. Okay, whatever was there in develop is now with master. Now the last thing is to push the master to your remote server, in my case to the GitHub page. Simple, we'll say git push origin master, and once it does that, we will go ahead and see in our GitHub page. Done. I go to my GitHub page and I refresh it, and if I go ahead and see here, you can see new file is actually added over here because this is the master branch, in the master branch. Now if you want to see how things have happened, go to insights and network. You can see that master and develop both pointing to same snapshot. Okay, Git snapshot is extremely important when it comes to Git. Okay, so guys, this was the simplest possible way where you can check out a branch, create a develop branch, do some changes, merge it back and push the merged code to your remote server or GitHub page. I think this is good enough for you to go ahead and do some practice before we proceed further on branching. So that's all I had for today, guys. Thanks a lot. Thanks for watching. Till the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.